About to get underway as the starting fives have been announced. Sit tight. We'll be back in just a moment. It's time for the NBA live on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan, and joining me tonight, Chris Webber and Greg Anthony, with our Hall of Famer David Aldridge reporting from the sideline. Hey, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. With the new G League Pathway program, some say that the NBA is competing now with college hoops for top high school players. G League President Sharif Abdur-Rahim said, "I don't think so. This is an opportunity for unique talents, a select group that are tracking toward the NBA. It's a different model from college. Guys, we'll see how this works out in the years to come."
DA, thanks a lot. Here are the five for the Clippers. Ivica Zubac is out there with Marcus Morris. Then it's Paul George. Then there's Kawhi Leonard. And it's Beverly in at the one. And for the Lakers, LeBron and Davis, the incredible forward pair. Green out there with Avery Bradley. And it's McGee in at the five. Hard tonight, Greg. Two teams with a lot of history that know each other very, very well.
And sometimes familiarity breeds contempt. Yeah. And that goes for the players, coaches, and fans. This one might get heated.
I'm sure you felt that way many times when you play.
Almost every time I took the floor.
Good.
You literally want to dislike your opponent.
Now, here's Bradley. Pass to McGee. Shoots over Zubats. Tries again, and that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
At this point of his career, McGee knows who he is, a hustler, an energy guy who uses his athleticism to his advantage. Well, there are a few players in the league that can match McGee's athleticism. I mean, his whole career, he's been a class above with his speed and leaping. He'll make the most of it on both ends of the court.
He's off on the first.
And see, Webb, you mentioned it with JaVale McGee. His vertical is off the charts.
Oh, yeah, he can get to alley-oops, GA, that nobody else can. The length and bounce he has is jaw-dropping. I mean, same goes for his shot-blocking abilities when he times it up.
And Morris has got the ball here for the Los Angeles Clippers. Leonard, the pass to Zubac. And it's JaVale McGee with the foul. That's his first foul.
A foul right off the bat. You hate to pick up your first one so quick.
The Lakers on D. Beverly deciding where to go with it. Left side, Leonard. Shot clock at five. Count that one.
And part of what makes Kawhi such a great player is that jump shot. You can't just worry about him attacking the basket.
Now, here's Bradley. Here's LeBron. And the rejection by Zubac. Beverly for three. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist.
And Beverly has wonderful moves and has a great stroke from downtown. Gotta love how he rises up with plenty of confidence.
Outside Bradley. Here's McGee. Paul George grabs the miss. Here now the Clippers. First 1:30 gone here in the first quarter. Leonard on the wing. The three. And again, it's the Clippers from deep.
Nice play, and you can see they're gathering momentum.
They've been a more cohesive team over this stretch, and that helps account for their lead.
Now here's LeBron. Shoots over Leonard. And LeBron with the basket, the assist by Bradley.
Oh, nice look by Bradley, moving it to the open man.
Outside, George. Shoots over Bradley. And it's George missing.
Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
Well, you're right. He'd take that 10 out of 10 times. He's not going to miss many of those. It's just 1 for 5 from the field now. I mean, they've come out flat. They need to pick up the energy.
Nothing that time. He's 0 for 2.
He gets the playground jumper and can't make good on it. You don't get many chances easier than that.
Leonard against LeBron. and then jammed down as he goes right over Ivica Zubac.
And James simply one of the best dunkers in NBA history, I have to say. Highly creative in how he throws it down.
Bounce pass from Beverly. Leonard kicks to Beverly. About 3 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Plenty of daylight on that shot.
Just phenomenal awareness by Beverly, just dishing the ball to the wide open man easily.
Lakers trail by five. James looking around. Leonard with the steal. And again, the Clippers good for two.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
And here's James. He'll bring it up for the Lakers. Pass to McGee. Back to LeBron. Nice ball movement here by the Lakers. Davis, the pass to Brantley. James against Leonard. Shot clock at six. Shoots over Leonard. It's hauled in by Zubac.
They know they can't give him that shot. The D's are over it. Not even giving him an inch of space.
And boy, he's got terrific feel on that jump shot. That's how George knocks down those catch-and-shoot jumpers in the blink of an eye.
Now, here's Bradley. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Over Leonard. And again, no good by the Lakers. On offense, here are the Clippers. They're on a 14-4 run right now. Shot from 12. That one misses. And the Lakers going the other way now. Davis up top, covered by Morris. Outside for Davis. James has a two-pointer. Offensive rebound. Second chance shot. And it's Davis missing.
Nothing less than that kind of defense will cut it against him. That's just great work inside.
And it's Leonard missing. Lakers trail by nine. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
And that one's good by Davis.
Defender plays tough, but Davis is tougher. Plays through the contact with authority.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here.
And LeBron James, still the face of the league as he goes into his mid-30s. The impact he's had on this sport is really immeasurable.
Come on, GA. I mean, he's one of the most recognizable athletes in the world. I mean, it's scary to think LeBron can still turn it on and take over when he needs to. And you know what? Playoff LeBron, he's a very good thing.
A platoon swap here for the Lakers. Big group substitution here for the Clippers. Harrell, he's checked in for Zubac. Green comes in for Marcus Morris. Landry Shamet's checked in for George. Lou Williams is subbed in for Patrick Beverley. Rondo dishes to Morris. Caldwell Pope outside. Tries it from the top of the key. It's hauled in by the Clippers.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Shamet finds Harrell. Outside Williams. This one for three. It's rebounded by Rondo. Lakers trail by nine. Williams with the defensive effort.
He doesn't get the finish, but the D's got to be quicker to rotate and stop him from getting to the rim.
The Lakers shooting pretty grave so far, about 23%. Rondo scanning the floor. The Lakers need to get a shot off here. Howard can't hit.
Nice work on the glass, but his defense was even better. Really has an impact on that shot.
Here's Williams. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Outside Rondo. High arcing shot. Outside Williams. Dishes it to Green. Knocked away. Rondo with the steal. He Here's Kuzma. No good, and they can't put an end to this drought. Williams against Rondo.
Now I think he lets the D get to him there, and he rushes it. I mean, he has plenty of space there if he just takes his time.
That's good from Howard on the assist by Kuzma.
Outstanding presence of mind. Howard is as dependable as he gets near the rim.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Rondo against Williams. Now the pass to Leonard. Shoots over Kuzma. Leonard with the bucket. Leonard's got 11 points.
Oh, don't forget about this fella for a second. He is the definition of dangerous.
And so the first quarter is in the books. Clippers ahead. They're up by 9. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports. A little bit earlier, we had a chance to chat with Kyle Kuzma, who loves playing alongside so much talent.
You know, for me, it's super cool just to learn, sit back, watch, but also compete against these guys. You know, that's something that I want to do. So to be around those guys and, you know, be in the foxhole with those guys is, you know, it's pretty incredible.
Well, Kuzma, Greg, has certainly learned a lot, proficient at the offensive end, and adding more to his game every day.
Yeah, I mean, he's been focused on improving the defense and rebounding, and much of that is due to the players he's been surrounded by.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Clippers?
What we saw in that first quarter, they won their matchups defensively.
Yeah, they really got after it. I mean, they made life extremely difficult for the shooters, which is why they hold this lead.
And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. And the Clippers, looking at who they've got, we've got Jermichael Green, Reggie Jackson out there with Williams, then there's Harrell, and it's Shamet in at the three slot. Pass to Rondo. Caldwell Pope outside. Back to Rondo. To the middle. Here's Howard. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. It's going to be on Montrezl Harrell.
Never easy trying to mark Howard. I mean, he's terrific at forcing the issue and getting the foul call.
And Dwight Howard, you know, not the same 35-minute-a-game player he once was, but I tell you what, when he's on the floor, he can still be every bit as effective.
Yeah, Howard can bully teams that go small against him. I mean, he provides a big body to deal with other strong centers. I mean, he also gives the team some great flexibility with how they match up.
And he can't get the first one. Greg, you've always said to have a winning team, you need franchise players. Talk about the specific qualities you look for in those superstars that can catapult a team to greatness.
It's a great question, Kevin. Talent really isn't enough. You know, whether you lead vocally or by example, the agenda has to be winning, and your best players really define who your team is going to be. So the franchise caliber player is a much needed asset.
And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Kevin, good evening. The Clippers were picked by many to win the title last year. Now, they didn't get it done, but Kawhi Leonard is not concerned. He said, "We've just got to keep getting better, keep fighting. It's about the right team peaking at the right time. Guys, they're hoping this season their talent and their fight will win out." Back to you.
We will see. Good stuff, DA. Thanks. Clippers leading by 9. There's the dish to George. Over Caldwell Pope. The Lakers with the rebound. Power George got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. The 15-footer, it's good. George has got six.
And the mid-range jumper really right in George's comfort zone. When he isn't blowing by guys and finishing at the rim, he's knocking that one down with consistency.
LeBron against George. LeBron outside. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. It's going to be on Montrezl Harrell.
James is a workhorse down deep. When he's close to the basket, you better wrap him up.
You know, even though LeBron doesn't go 100% every minute of every game in the season, G.A., he still knows when to turn it on.
And for someone at his age, that is something you have to know how to do. You can see when LeBron kicks it into that next
shoot
gear.
Two.
Can't keep it on all the time, but he's still able to take over when he needs to.
And he makes the first.
Oh, you love how effortless James makes this game look. Everything comes easy to him.
Some changes for the Lakers. JaVale McGee's checked in for Howard. Green comes in for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. And Bradley's subbed in for Alex Caruso. Zubats is checked in for the Clippers. Patrick Beverley comes in for Lou Williams. No good on the second free throw.
And they're getting to the line a lot in this quarter, guys, and it hasn't been by accident.
Here's George. It's good from about 19 feet. George has got the lead up to 12 now for the Clippers.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Oh, yeah, and that's what you love about him. He shows no mercy, even with the comfortable lead.
And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a three-point play chance here for him.
Shooting one.
That sends JaVale McGee to the free throw line. That's on Reggie Jackson. Lakers shooting their seventh attempt at the foul line in this one. Clippers leading by nine. Pass to Zubats. Back to Jackson. George looking over the floor. Knocks down the three ball. George has got seven now in this quarter.
They couldn't have asked for much more from him today. He's been a key force in their offense.
LeBron up top, defended by George. James, the pass to Bradley. Basket counts.
And that's where he's most comfortable. Bradley crafting his game to excel in the catch and shoot.
And so George will bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. George double-teamed, passes it to Beverly. No good from outside. Lakers trail by 10. Oh, and there's the alley-oop and the slam dunk by McGee.
And you see why McGee's teammates lob it up his way? Because they know he can go up and get it.
LeBron against George. And it's George finishing it off.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat. The pass to Green. Trying to find Bradley, gets it to him. Some solid defense there from Jackson. Clippers leading by 10. Kicks it to George. Out of bounds, the Lakers will take possession. How about that strong defensive performance for this half's Mobile One block?
And he's all over that shot, has it read the whole way, and gets the position he needs to make a play.
Markieff Morris is checked in for the Lakers. And the Clippers with a change here, too. Leonard, he's checked in for Reggie Jackson. Outside, Davis. Plenty of space. No good that time. And the Clippers will come the other way. Here's George. Morris with the rebound.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Davis kicks to James. Pass to Bradley. Here's Morris. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Just four to shoot. From deep. The Lakers get it back in a new 14.
Wow. Morris is a physical guy. Solid at staying active on the boards and gobbling up these rebounds.
Beverly, the pass to Leonard. Over Bradley. And again, no good by the Clippers. Lakers trail by eight. A putback. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
From deep, George. The Clippers rebound, and that one is good. And the Clippers lead by eight.
And that's why you never stop working in the paint at either end of the floor.
Lakers have gone 6-12 in the second quarter, right at the 50% mark from the field. Bradley passes to Morris. And now the Clippers on the break. Lob pass to George. Hammers the alley-oop through.
And a little verticality there from George, not to mention the timing between those two on the alley-oop.
And the Lakers decide to take their first timeout here. We know how important the draft is, Greg. It can shape an organization. Talk about some of the best draft day deals of the last couple decades. There have been a lot of them.
Oh, there have been a few. I mean, just coming to mind here recently, how about when Kawhi was traded to the Spurs? That was a huge get. Go back
George
to how
Hill.
About Kobe going to the Lakers? Mikhail and Parrish coming to the Celtics. I mean, we've seen that happen quite a bit. And I tell you what, boy, it can really transform a franchise's future.
Puts it up. And again, the Lakers, no good.
I love the anticipation defensively there to get into the perfect spot.
Shamet, that's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Shamet's got the lead up to 13 now for the Clippers.
Yeah, I love the court awareness from Kawhi there. Dependable at getting it to his uncovered teammates.
Outside Rondo. To end the run. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
I mean, having a floor general like Rondo on the court instantly elevates your offense. He does everything he can to bring out the best in his team.
The Lakers have shot 3 of 7 at the foul line.
Definitely an area where they can improve. Only 73% as a team from the line last year.
That one is off. And the Lakers making a change here. Caldwell Pope's checked in. And the Clippers with a change here, too. Williams has checked in. And he's good on the second. 43 seconds left in the second quarter. He makes that one drop, only a second in five tries.
What a score this guy is. Inside, outside, mid-range. Williams is capable of doing damage from anywhere.
Caldwell Pope up top. He's covered by Shamet. And good that time. Caldwell Pope's got 4 points in the quarter. And so here are the Clippers. Now here's Leonard. 11 points in the game. And here is Williams.
Well, I'll tell you this. When Rondo is zeroed in defensively, he can be a stopper.
And the first half is now in the books. Clippers lead by 12. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks so much. Kawhi, you seem to be so at ease out there. How much is that helping your game?
It's helping me out a lot. Just coming in the game relaxed, just with more intensity. I mean, my teammates are getting me involved on the offensive end. I'm playing great on defense. We just got to keep it up second half and not let it up.
Hey, Kawhi, thank you very much for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, thank you, David. And folks, don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number 3.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back to 2K Sports, everybody. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Let's talk about that first half. Paul George taking care of business in this one. He had 27 points, 13 rebounds, and 5 assists. And a little redemption for him tonight. In their previous game, he was not at his best. What'd you think, Shaq, about the first half we saw from the Clippers?
Listen, man, I just touched PG. I got to get a Band-Aid. This boy is so sharp. Guy had to overcome injuries, play alongside new teammates every few years. But he's terrific at both ends of the floor.
And, Kenny, how about what you saw from the Lakers?
Well, sometimes you get too comfortable playing at home. This team played tonight like it's no urgency. And now they dug themselves a hole, and the energy level to get out of it is going to be extraordinary. We'll see if they come out of the tunnel with some fire in the second half, because they're going to need it.
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side.
My brother...